I'm at max capacity on Facebook, mm-hmm. been there for 5 years, and I also have an additional 3,000 followers. I have about 4,500 followers on Instagram and Twitter and things of that nature. So I use social media, and that helps me a lot in my business. I can honestly say social media has helped me more than me going out here passing out business cards.
Yes, that's good.
Well, social media is a better way of marketing, plus it's inexpensive. To run campaigns and stuff like that. You also, like today's youth, that's pretty much what they are on, their technology. They even have iPods in school and stuff like that, doing reports on computers. So everything is starting to turn to the computer age, so I believe that's the best way of marketing, best for the budget as well. I definitely use social media. It's been a big part of my success.
Social media is really good, but of course, I mean, it's, for me in particular, we have a certain demographic that we target, what we're looking for. Of course, most people typically, and we can provide these kind of services to them, but typically if they're too young, they won't see the responsibility in actually looking to, you know, take care of their money or save. That's not a priority for them. So we do have a target market, and social media would be great, but we do need other advertising resources as well to give us a bigger market we can reach. So of course, different, we do have agents as well too that are doing what we do, but that growth can be, it can be more exponential growth if we had the resources financially to grow the business. It's just money. Bottom line, it's just money. I'm just going to be very direct with you. It's money.
For me, I would be in the contrast. I am not that social on social media. And I built my business with one-on-one interaction, giving great service one-on-one, and that person would tell that business, and that business would come and support, which just spread the spider web. So I am interested in becoming more social. So in the future, I know that it's necessary for exponential growth, but.
And that's actually where we come in for, we're trying to get experience for our business, and we're getting our experience through them. We're learning, or we've learned, or like she said, have knowledge in how to reach, you know, larger masses. And one of the things that we have trained is social networks. So we're hopefully going to be providing that kind of, you know, image or service to our fellow YIN members so that they can get out there if they don't have it started themselves, help them run it, help them, you know, market it, help them push it out and get it to the youth. Or just get it to people and masses in general. So hopefully that's where we'll come in for our fellow YIN members and put our skills to use.
So that's when we got our degree in, right? Like I said, we're putting our degree to work. Went to school for public relations, and that's what we'll do for you all.
For me, it definitely is in creation of Beauty Hair Spa. I did intensive research on companies that are large and that have been around for decades. And I don't believe in reinventing the wheel all the time, but definitely using these successful platforms that are already here for us to observe and allowing that to be a benefit to me and everyone else as well. So in the creation of my business, I created the business so that it could be duplicated. I study franchise businesses, so in the beginning, that was definitely a goal of mine, not to be behind the chair decades in, but to allow myself to be a big business.
In addition to what she said, I think that diversity is gold. You have to be diverse, you have to be open-minded, and you have to stay outside the box. Once you get out of it, stay out of it, close it, kick it. So to me, diversity is everything. So yeah, I agree 100% with what she said.
Well, I have a mentor, and he's very wealthy, and he builds oil refinery rigs out in the ocean. And when I first met him, he told me one thing. He said the only color of power is green.
Green.
So with that being said, if you have green, I'm working with you.
the saying that everybody uses, there's always somebody that's better than you. So, to say that, you know, if somebody's better than you, they've probably done it before you. So, I always look at, you know, people before me, like my father, has his own company, Best Rate Tree Service. So I model from him. And also I see, you know, flaws and different things, whatever. So I try to make it where I can look at bigger people that's at a bigger plateau, whatever, to model them. And I work with a whole bunch of, you know, diverse people. I'm glad that I got a business that I can actually see new and different people, whatever. Money's granted too, so.
I guess we're saying we're not just trying to reach just one. We're extending our services to everybody.
Good morning again. My name is Maria Macon. I'm the proud owner of Polish Inc., which has been in Charlotte 38 years. Polish Inc. is a business consulting technical writing firm. I primarily set up 501c3 nonprofit organizations. I'm a certified grant specialist. In my work that I do on a daily basis, and the other thing I need to say, I've been self-employed since I was 18 years old. So it was a natural, and I'm not going to tell you how old I am, but a natural draw would be to those individuals that were young business owners. Most of the people, and this is only 6 of the total 17 people that are in YEN, but most of the business owners that I've met are clients of mine. And I realized that I had a file cabinet of clients that were 30 and under doing business. And they come to me to find out about getting business license, getting incorporated, getting your foundation, which I call your infrastructure, in place. And these young people came to me with that. Some of them gravitated through me mentoring them. So as a result, I said, all of these business people, and they're coming and paying, they're young, so they're paying money to me to do things that I could do in a give back situation, because I did not have the support in my family. My mom and my dad always said, when are you gonna go get a job? And they never saw working for myself as that's my job. My job is going and getting clients. So at any rate, I did not want our future generation to have to go through the thing of going to work, not knowing what to do, getting laid off, et cetera, et cetera. I wanted them to know that they can start businesses based on whatever it is they're doing. If you're baking cupcakes, then you can start a business. You're a baker. And I just believe in the entrepreneurial spirit. So YEN started by just them coming and sitting and talking with me. And we started meeting recently. We started meeting at first at Denny's. We were meeting at Denny's. And I just started imparting information, getting your business license, where to go get the business license, how to get the business license. What do you do for financing? Right now, YEN is looking at, and they come up with, an incubator type situation, and we all learned that from the Sept and from Louise Seller. So they wanted an incubator, they wanted to start a credit union. It made sense to me to work with them with the resources that I have. Many in this room are resources that I had that helped me. So with those resources, I figured if you knew who they were, and if you knew what it was you could do to help them, that it would start on a way, and we would actually start a microcosm. Almost, I think it was one of the ones Amber that brought up, the Black Wall Street. So they studied Black Wall Street, how it started. They studied, they've been down to the license. All of them are licensed business owners. They're working on business plan, stock options. There are some of these things that are not taught in the African-American community and not taught in school. Your stock offer packages, your stock off options, getting incorporated. You have 1,000 shares that you can let. What does let mean? To sell. They needed to know these kind of things. That's why you hear them talking about finances. They get a lot of training. We work Sundays, We take our Sundays from 3:30 to 5:30, and we sit and talk about what do you need to do? What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? What are you doing? How do you get your client? What happens when a client doesn't pay? What happens when you have to collect? So we do all of these things. Right now, what we need, this is a 12-week, we decided. It's a 12-week course. They will be ending in about five more weeks, they will be ending and looking for the next group of people. I've heard many of you say, I have a son or a daughter that's in school, they are starting their business, they want a business. Send them to YAM for the information. At this point, they pay nothing to get the training. I sacrifice my week in preparing what I want them to know, and Sundays I sacrifice after church from 3:30 to 5:30, although we may be there to sit, just talking about the business and how to run your business. It's challenging because young people have ideas. It's challenging and it's rewarding because I get to stay young looking at all the new ideas that are coming up. I get to hear things that are amazing that young people are doing. And I want to close that gap between the senior citizens, the adults, and young people. That should not be a gap. We are the elders. We are the elders. We should be eldering. Instead of trying to hang out with them, we need to be eldering and giving them that instructions that they need. And they need to be able to come to us, to the community. My time is up. Come to the community and get the resource. You hear them talking about community. That's where they need to be. That community looks like me, looks like you, looks like you. That's all of us. But we need to come together and recognize that if we don't work with our future, then our future is doomed. And not every kid wants to walk around with his pants hanging down and with a handout asking you for a dollar or a dime on the street. Not everybody wants to do that. So what I wanted to do was bring in to you Young Entrepreneur Network. Bring them to you. You cannot not know their names. Jennifer, Jessica, Chris, Marquay, Jefferson, Amber, Tequila. These are names of the businesses that will be coming up. I feel comfortable with my future. Social Security will be alive if we keep it alive in our young folks.
Yes.